नमस्कार, मायसेल्फ लेफ्टनंट डॉक्टर प्रशांत आंबेकर फ्रॉम धरमपेठ एमपी देव मेमोरियल सायन्स कॉलेज नागपूर.
एंड आई एम डॉक्टर जसमीर रंधावा आंबेकर फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज नागपूर. वेलकम यू ऑल टू द एक्सपेरिमेंटल मॉड्यूल ऑन ट्रांजिस्टर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी आर डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिंग द स्टडी ऑफ आउटपुट एंड इनपुट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एन पी एन ट्रांजिस्टर using XPIES platform. For the study of output characteristics, we use the circuit in common emitter mode. Emitter is maintained common to the input side and output side. Here we are using a NPN type of transistor, which is N2222A. PACE is connected to a variable power supply PV2 through 100 kilo ohm resistance. The base current is used is measured in microamps. Collector terminal is connected to a variable power supply PV1 through a resistance of 1 kilo ohm, and collector current is measured in milliamps. The output voltage is measured between collector and emitter as VCE. For using this circuit, the two parameters that we can measure are output impedance RO and current gain beta. Output impedance is the variation in collector voltage with respect to change in collector current. The current gain beta is defined as change in collector current with respect to change in base current at some particular value of collector voltage. When we plot output characteristics, we get the variation in collector voltage with the variation in collector current for different values of base current IB. Here we can see that the collector current initially increases and then attains some saturation value. For higher value of base current, we get higher value of collector current because the transistor here is in amplifier mode. The output impedance RO is calculated or is obtained by taking the value of delta VC on x-axis and delta IC on y-axis. So 1 upon slope of the curve will give us the value of RO, that is output impedance. The current gain beta is measured for a particular value of VC. The delta IC is obtained from these selecting any two points corresponding to VC. This gives us delta IC, and the corresponding variation in the base current gives us delta IB. So that gives us the current gain beta.
Friends, we have just seen the theoretical aspect and circuit diagram of the output characteristics of the transistor. Now the same transistor, NPN transistor, is connected over here, of which this terminal is connected to the ground. That means this is emitter. This terminal is connected to 100 kilo ohm resistance. That means this connection is made to the base of the transistor, and you can see this blue line over here, which is again connected to via 1 kilo ohm resistance, that is the collector of the transistor. Now the as we have seen in the circuit diagram, the emitter is directly connected to ground, and the ground is connected to the ground of the exercise kit, any one of these black connection. Secondly, the collector is connected to the A1, that means we have to take the signal from this, we have to measure the signal from this, that's why we have connected it to the A1 terminal of the exercise kit. The base is connected to power supply, and that is connected via PV2, which is programmable voltage 2. Similarly, the collector is also connected to the PV1, that is programmable voltage 1, and which is this line you can see, which is again connected via 1 kilo ohm resistance to the collector. And at the same time, the as we have made the connections of the collector and we are measuring it via or through A1, similar connection I have made for measuring the value of the potential at the base. That means the base of the transistor is connected via this line to the A2. So this is overall connections what we have made. Now we shall go for the experimental trial. Let us begin with the experimental part. Now I have opened the XWISE software window. Now I'll go to electronics and select NPN output characteristics. I will keep the circuit diagram here for ready reference. Now by offering a very small voltage, say 0.5 volt, I will start with my experiment, and the characteristics for 0.5 volt appearing over here. Now this 0.5 volt is nothing but the voltage applied at the input, so that I could get the constant IB, say here 1.00 microampere. Similarly, I will increase the voltage a bit and again start my voltage characteristics, and it will appear like this. Again I will increase the voltage 0.8 volt, start it again, and the characteristics will appear like this. You can see the IB is increased here and it is 2.133 microamps. For 1 volt, I will start another set of observations and I am getting this characteristics. I will increase it a bit more again, and similar characteristics will appear over here. I will try as much as possible voltages at the input and the characteristics will appear here. Now you may ask that what is the use of these many curves and all this thing. So after getting the exact all values, we can find out beta and some other parameters of the transistor. Now this graph, I can save it or export the file itself in the CSV format. I will export it and save by, say, the initial I will overwrite here. You can change the name of the file and I will save it. I will close the window and this file is appearing here. Now let us do some calculations and analysis. For calculating output impedance RO, that is equals to delta VC by delta IC, we take reciprocal of slope. For that we select one set of observations and we perform some operation on it. Here I will select this third observation set, X and Y you can see here. x and y of a one set of observation and insert a plot x y scatter, and you are getting this characteristics over here. But we have to take slope of this line, not this. This is our active region. So what I'll do, I will have this much on the graph first and then do some operation on it. So I will select this, say from 0.8 volt or so. Even I am getting this line, so I will go further, say here, and now I am getting this kind of graph. I will apply the trade line, which is linear in nature, and also I will display the equation on the graph. Now this equation is a equation of a straight line, and slope is always calculated by using straight line portion of the graph. Now this is y equals to mx plus c. So this m I have to take into consideration. So I will note that slope, say 0.0162. I will take reciprocal of this because my y-axis is current and x-axis is voltage. So I will have to take the reciprocal of this. So I will simply use a basic operation in Excel. This is P7. So I have selected this and I got this basic slope or reciprocal of slope rather. Now my y-axis is having milliamps, as we have seen in the earlier graphs, and x-axis in volt. So this is delta V by I now, this slope, and this is I by V. So I will have to multiply this by 1000 so as to get the exact value of the resistance. So RO, you can have the value of RO equals to Q7 multiplied by and that's come to be this much ohms. So 61,728.4 ohms I am getting here. This is the output impedance of. Now you can perform the sets or the calculations for other sets of observation also and take the mean of the RO so that you could get more accuracy in your observation or result. Now in order to find beta of the transistor, that means delta IC by delta IB, we can have the values of delta IC, that means IC is on y-axis of this graph and IBs are constant kept for each observation or set of observation. Now we will select a common point, say VCE at 1, that means constant VCE. I will be taking this delta IB, so this IB, this IB, this IB, this IB and this IB at different ICs. So if I consider this data,
it will appear like this. I have discarded the first and the last observation set because the first was not proper as the transistor was not in on position, and the last was beyond the limit of our measurement. Therefore, I have selected good data, and in that data I could get this. I have highlighted it. Now we have to select the ICs for different observations. Say for first, that means for IB equals to 0.685, I am getting 0.102578. So this is IB and this is IC. Similarly, I will write for the values of IB first. Those are 2.133. I have already noted them. 3.927. Third one and fourth one, 5.804. And the last one, 7.715. So these are my values of IB, and now I will select this one. Similarly, I will go for other values. I will paste it here. And the last value I am getting, and paste it here. Now I will plot, insert, XY scatter. I am getting a straight line over here. Now again, in as we have done it earlier, I will add a trail line with linear scaling, and also I will display its equation. So I am getting this value over here, that is 0.5216, that is 0.5216. So this is the slope. You might have observed that my IB is in microamps and IC is in milliamps. So what I will have to do, I will have to multiply it by 1000 so that I could get the exact value. Now I will simply use a simple formula: 1000 times this and enter. Now 521.6 is my beta. So we have calculated output impedance RO and beta, that is current amplification factor of a transistor.
For the input characteristics of the transistor, NPN transistor, I will simply change the potentials so that my fixed voltage will be at VCE and the input voltage VBE versus IB will be measured. So I will simply shift my voltages. This is actually collector voltage in earlier case. Now I am shifting it to here, and the this is now my base voltage, so I will connect it here. Similarly, the yellow line is collector measuring over here now, and this blue line is collector measuring. So I will start the experiment.
Let us start taking the observation for input characteristics using XSPICE module. We will select electronics and NPN transistor from the drop down. The circuit connections are also seen here. We have just made a changes because we want variable power supply at the input. So PV1 is connected to the base side and PV2 is connected to the collector side, which we will be keeping fixed, and same is done for the measurement section, that A1 and A2 are interchanged. Now we will fix the collector voltage at 1 volt and start taking observation. We are observing the variation of base current IB with the base emitter voltage. As we all are aware that emitter base junction is forward bias and collector base junction is maintained reverse bias. Therefore, emitter base junction characteristics are similar to a forward bias diode characteristics, and the cut-in voltage is seen at about 0.6 volt. We will change the collector voltage to one more value, 2 volt, and start one more set of observation. We are observing that the current is, or the cut-in voltage is slightly increased, and similar graph is seen as that of 1 volt. Even if you go for the collector voltage at 3 and start taking observation, a very close curve is observed with very small variation in the voltages. We will take this data for the calculation of input impedance. The CSV file is exported and we are saving this file as trans input. From this data, we will try to calculate the value of input impedance RI. We'll go back to the folder, trans input is open. It is a CSV file, comma separated value file. Open it in Excel platform as we have done for the previous calculations. We will select only one of these three graphs that we have plotted. We will go for plotting of the graph, select data points, scatter, and we are getting the curve. See, the cut-in voltage is seen at 0.6. The diode is going into conduction region, and we should, for input impedance, we should calculate the slope of the linear portion of the graph after it is well in forward bias mode, means after cut-in voltage. So we will discard few initial observations for the sake of calculation. We should go, small curvature is seen here. So we should go to some more reduction in data points. Now it is getting a straight line nature, and we'll fit a trade line to get the slope of the curve. Linear regression is fitted because we want it to be a straight line, and we'll select display equation of chart so that we could read the value of slope directly. We can see that the slope is coming 136.78. Now This slope is actually delta I upon delta V, because on y-axis we have current, which is in microamps, and we want resistance, input resistance, so we need to take reciprocal of this dV upon dI. So we'll do 1 upon slope, and because current is in microamps, we need to multiply this value with 10 raised to power 6. But we have used the output platform for the study of input characteristics. We had connected an additional milliammeter in the input side, and we have seen that the current is to be multiplied by a factor of 10 so that we get the correct value of input impedance. So instead of multiplying by 10 raised to power 6, we will multiply it by 10 raised to power 5. And we get the input impedance as 731 ohms. We have calculated the output impedance and input impedance by considering only one set of observation. Actually, we should perform the experiment with good number of set of observations to get true value of the parameters we are determining. The sample results could be the value of output impedance we have found of the order of 61.7 kilo ohms, and input impedance is of the order of 731 ohms. The current amplification factor is found to be around 521. While performing this experiment, certain precautions have been taken care of, that while handling the power supply, we should take care that it should not get short-circuited. The two terminals should not touch each other. And while inserting the component into breadboards or jumper wires into the breadboard, we should do it gently so that we won't damage the breadboard. Thank you.